So yeah, start my recording here. There we go. So yeah, I don't feel like going to bed. So it's thunderstormy and it's hot now, it's humid. Not gonna be comfortable. Too awake, I just made some tea. So it's a good enough excuse. I know exactly where I'm going. Consulted my wife and she convinced me which path to take. So, actually go to this side of the house. 3D maps will be the end of me one day. I stand by it. So, okay, yeah, I should also explain this too. If you push square on the PlayStation controller, it comes up with your key items. And some people react to different things. So if you use the Hero's Medal on him, that's how you trigger it, and he's going to be the path we're going to take. Speaks French. I don't know why I'm going with this guy, but yeah. They always have something interesting when they join your party, too. It's not just, oh, they joined your party. It's always going to be gracefully, or it's going to be forcefully, or some other thing along those lines. So we need a name fitting of him. I don't have any French names. Ah, that's what I'll do. We will do... I am Canadian, so I pronounce this a little bit differently than everyone else. It's not Guy, it's Guy. Like Guy Lafleur. Unfortunately, we do need him. So we will switch him out. And this also shows how gross the character stuff is. You can see it scrolling and scrolling, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 rows of characters, which is beyond ridiculous. Yeah. Never been too big of a fan of him, but we will allocate some stuff to him. I see, yeah. So we'll give him the cure. We'll do cure plus one. Fireball and a magma bomb. And actually, no, two fireballs. He'll just be fire. That'll be good. Although he's technically water. Yeah. Do I have any other water things? Not really. We're going to have to just injure. Oh well. I'll have to go buy him some more elements later, something that suit him, but a bit too lazy. Well, there's an element shop on the way out of town, so I guess I'll buy a couple. Otherwise, I'm going to have to sit there and... I guess I should. It's the right thing to do. So let's get ice. Let's get. Well, I have 240. So one ice lance and two aqua beams in. Oh, wait. I saw heal there. Heal's good. Heal's very good. Don't know if I can actually sell anything here. Oh, I can. Okay, that's good. $1 away. Thank you for that. You know what? We'll just sell one. One tablet here. Because we have obviously way more than enough, and we only need $1. So yeah, heal is a good one. Cures the lower rank stuff. So elements, allocate. We'll replace that. We will keep Magma Bomb on, though. That and Aqua Beam. Oops. What did I just say? There. Wait. Oh, minus one. Whoops, I went around the... Yeah, you can weaken spells as well. Okay, yeah, there you go. That's what we'll do. That way we have the heal and cure, so he'll... What's his stats? Really, really pathetic, actually. We're going to get him some new equipment first before we go to the place. Well, first of all, Sean's going to be in the party for, obviously, a while, so we'll give him that. In case I switch out. Second, give him some defense here. Yeah, he can find a hero set, essentially. It takes up all the inventory for his accessories. I don't know if it's worth it or not. Either way, we'll go to the blacksmith and get him a new weapon, though. I guess new weapons in general. Because I'm not going to have a chance to get some new ones. And then after that, we'll politely walk towards Viper Manor. Which I'm sure nothing will go problematic. Thank you. 3D maps. The Arcadia Dragoons. Dragoons, I should say. I don't want... Yeah, let's get rid of that one thing so I get a copper. Because no matter what, I'm going to get a black... not black. I'm sorry. A bone axe if I get Karsh. Iron, iron, iron. So I'm not going to be able to get that one. I got $1. Okay, one sec here. We're gonna have to... Okay, fine then. Let's sell this one then. And... Yeah, we're not selling that one anytime soon. Oh, wait. Can't I disassemble the... Oh, that's copper. Well, that turns into iron. Eh, not worth it. The damage difference would be... distinguishable, but not, oh, they're all equipped. Can I not sell... Guy's not paying rent. Sorry, Gi, not Guy. I wonder how long I'm going to keep that up before I start calling him Guy. See, I really should go fight something. Yeah, we'll go to the forest and fight a couple battles and get some money. With the Profiteer's Purse, it shouldn't take long. And come back and forge, because the battle I'm going to be doing at the front gate is not going to be pleasant. If I can get through here, because I took a separate path now, so I might be... Oh, that's all. Okay, fine. So yeah, it locked me out because I picked Pierre's path. So we'll just go back to the canyon here then. It's not that bad. Ooh, I want to go into the north one, thank you. Not too many enemies. I don't know if the bird's back or not. Don't think he is. He's not supposed to be a second fight. He's not yet. Let's quickly battle a couple of these things. There's a big one here. Did I say anger? Wait, have I ever fought the big one before? I have. Ankle biters. Oh, he missed. Oh, come on. Oh, good, I got dash and slash. I guess at 3 stars, you're able to unlock... See, she's able to do stuff. Maiden hand. We're gonna do that because it's funny. I've killed the end boss with that move before. Calculated how much damage I did in total and I killed it. Fireball isn't that bad. You can still. Okay, I guess going. Yeah, we'll go in and out of the south exit here and see if we can get a couple free. Free battles. I just need a little bit more money. So, Profiteer Purse. Yeah, that gave me about 100, so. We'll do this probably 2 more times and just go get at least a weapon for Shawnee. At minimum. Because it's pretty annoying having, is there a Mama Dingo? Oh, good, there is. I know it's fire versus fire, but whatever. There you go. They're puppies. What else do you expect them to do, right? Let's use the water move on them. This guy's not filling me with very much confidence. Great swordsman or not. For 2 gold. I'll see if I can go up and fight one more thing. I think that's enough if I were to sell the fireball elements at Lisa's shop. That I'd be able to at least get us a new weapon for Shawnee. I don't think it costs that much. I know I blew a lot of my money on the tablets, but that will pay off in dividends later. Pretty sure there's always an enemy up here. Maybe he'll come with a dodo, who knows. Don't know why he was there. To be fair, I never really fought here very often, so. Oh, dodo is here. Alright then. I do love their faces when they run. They're adorable. Oh, it's weak. That's fine, you can do that. Because you're green. There you go. So yeah, you're green, so I can use that and get good damage on you. It's not doing well. To be fair, I think that's the whole point of him, is once you get all 3 parts, he's apparently very good. I never bothered to use him, so I wouldn't know. Huh? He got some HP back, so good for him. We'll just keep... Nah, he's gonna hit... Okay, that's fine, you can dodge. I wonder why the dodo's here, though. It's really bugging me. I guess he's more common than I thought he was, but... Made in hand. I think that's based on magic, not based on attack, too, so... Nope, based on attack. Doesn't like spells being used on him. There we go. See who he kills. Oh, it's no good. I don't have a revive yet, so it's kind of annoying. Oh, lordy. I guess if it came down to it, we'd all be dead because of him. Just defend. Even Kid does more damage. There you go. Wait, how much in total? Oh yeah, no, that gives you a lot. I have 400 now. So yeah, I'll definitely take that. Now I'll have to heal up Sarah in a bit. Actually, I'll just do that now before I forget and get caught in a boss battle for no reason. Oh, he has pathetic accuracy though. He only has 80. But his attack doesn't reflect that. Didn't check his magic though. I don't know if he's better at magic or not. Not used to him at all. Like, oh, jeez. Don't normally take this path, but gonna have to. So this guy got at least one new weapon, because that'll at least push me over the edge for being able to do the next boss battle pretty easily. At least one. If I can get more, then all the better, but pretty sure with 400 gold I'd be able to, or whatever currency they use. G. I assume gold then. So, let's do... Copper Swallow. No, there's no... Thank you. Don't have enough for that. Bronze sword. You know what, no matter what, I'm gonna have to get one, so I'll do that. And can I make bronze mail? Oh, I don't have enough money. Okay. 200. No, I can try to sell something for that. Yeah, let's look here. Yes, I know iron, blah blah blah. Quiet people. Can I not unequip it? Oh, that's annoying. Well, either way, I don't need the sea swallow anymore. And she has a special on. So we can at least sell those for getting over the 200 mark. To get the copper thing. So, okay, that's still equipped, my bad. I guess I should just, no, you know what, no, bone sword, I just bought the bronze sword. Backwards. Oh wow, his attack went up like 3, whoop-de-doo. He really is not a good character. Sell, thank you. Getting ahead of myself here. Sell the bone sword. Forge the armor of the bronze mail. I have no more copper left. Okay. That's fine. Because I think... Yeah, with the less HP, she should have that. So, okay, there we go. Now let's go walk in Viper Manor. Wait, Sean should equip his thing before I get killed for no reason. Oh no, he has this. Okay, cool. Everyone's already equipped then. I'm ahead of myself and behind myself at the same time. Phenomenal. Scary man on the poster when I walked by was, his name is Nikki. He's one of the characters you can get if you choose to go through the forest path. Can't remember if Mickey... Mickey? Well, the female singer of, I want to call them Radical Dreamers. Make sure I save it, because I probably will die if I'm not careful. But like in every game I play, I always take boss battles very seriously, so... I'm not taking Kid with me, because Lena has better... There we go. She has better magic and healing capabilities. I do like how they use the hero's medal as a... Oh, heck yeah, we can. That's the whole point we're here. Oh, the dragoons. Perfectly symmetrical palm trees. So we've got to make sure that we have element power. Did I equip her weapon? I don't think so. No, no, it said CU 29. Or whatever it was, right? So... Actually, better thing, what element are they? Oh, had a cough there. Okay, there, yeah, so you can hit him with green here for pretty good damage then. Yeah, that random spell I picked up, possibly from the dodo. So, and you're gonna be pointless, so we're gonna poke. So pointless. Magma bomb hits all? Yeah, okay, cool. We'll do that then. You can't win with this guy. 7. Oh, lordy. Did I pick the wrong horse? Okay, so it's gonna be like 2 versus a couple people, basically, for a while, because I don't think I can... There you go. They take the counter to the boss, so... He's a whopping 4 strength. Oh, lordy. The person with the spatula has 9. So. Still 9. And he gained 1. Okay. So he's 1/4 stronger than he was before. Ugh, that's gross. Not a bad thing, but still. Yeah, this is now gonna suck if I'm not careful. Yes, I am that stupid to walk through the front gate. Mainly because I want to fight their friend. And their friend is just like them, is a pun, but he's a condiment. I agreeingly agree. Oh, I hate that guy's speeches. Or speech mannerisms. Yeah. Not ketchup, but ketchup. And there's a reason he's... Yeah. They must have had a lot of fun. Why did you take out the guy who actually can attack? Why couldn't you attack Gi? That would have been so much better. Well, Sean's dead. Thankfully, they are still considered semi-tutorial bosses. Perhaps. Always perhaps. But either way. So we will... Actually, we'll attack for one more. Okay, that's fine. You can hit for that little bit of damage. I just want to use heal plus one on, there you go, Shawnee. Want to make sure I get... he is useless. Alright. Okay, they're all yellow as well, so... she can do a good amount of damage with that. So we will just use a straight tablet. It only takes up one... Uses up per turn for a while though, but... 30, yeah. Oh, thankfully I did load him with a bunch of spells. I guess. Oh, don't strengthen big guy. Oh, good. I was gonna say, I can deal with that little guy, but... You know, fine, we'll actually keep targeting this guy. We should get rid of the guy who has strengthen. Technically, I should be taking out the other guy because he can lower my defenses, and if he does that, then it'll be quite a bit more annoying than the other one, but... Should be fine. Yeah, okay, cool. Well, I should do probably 40-ish damage, so should be worth using it. 26. Oh, yeah. Yeah, knocks out both of them, so now it's a 2-on-1. I lost a useless guy, so what's the harm? You know what, no, we'll just actually just use a tablet on... No, we'll just use a tablet on Sean. I shouldn't really, because... Well, he can't redo that again, because they're knocked unconscious. But it was a fire elemental move, at least. Big guy can dodge, apparently. I'll use Electro Jolt and screw things up here. I don't want those three reds up there in case he does have a fire move. That's fine. I'm more than happy to dodge. Oh, okay. Well, we're just gonna use another tablet. Got her HP up, and then now she'll be... It's a shame I don't have revive yet, though. Eh, 17's not bad. Stats back versus stamina. Sure, we'll use dash and slash. Gotta mess up that red up there. I don't want that there for safety reasons. Oh, he's getting weak, so that's something. Hey, his is about as good as Gi. He should be pretty close now, I think. Is that it? There you go, I think so. He's not a fun fight, though. He can go south real. Oh, he has a great mustache. So. We have to restock. This is the thing you have to make sure you do as well. If you have, you replace them. Sorry, you replace them if you use them. And actually, I think everyone got some more spells anyway. No, I want... I got a lot of money there, actually. I got a lot of money. Well, anyway. She should get Aqua Beam. And Fireball. Go up there. Actually, no. Magma Bomb should go up there. And did he get any? Not really. Aqua Beam. Just because he needs something up there. Sean got quite a bit. Let's put on the fireballs. I can't do another set of tablets. Okay. There's an item. Sometimes it's easy to forget this item there. Oh, right. There is an equipment thing, too. Yeah, that used to drive my my buddy nuts. Because it's no longer a proper ratio. She will have a lot more HP in battle. Yeah, no one's going to come to the front gate until nightfall. Besides, I only have one map there, and it's always based on night, so... But yeah, if you choose Guile's Path, you go to Kocha? What about Sarah? I can't remember if I can just straight up kill them. Cool, I can. Awesome. Really fast battle loading. No, not fireball. Did I put a magma ball on? I didn't. Oh, that's a shame. We'll attack that guy then with that. Something interesting about her being named Sarah? Chuxna? Oh, so hello. I really gotta check if she has the right weapon on. The damage doesn't seem right now, but to be fair, she's not the strongest. That should kill both those two little guys there. And then the worthless guy. Oh, lordy. Okay, let's see if he can even do any damage. Yeah. Yeah, technically it is Janice's sister's name. Yeah, no, it's... I named Lena after my wife. So. Please die. There we go. More copper. I don't mind that. I don't think I can enter, can I? Yeah, no, I need to get the... Okay, first of all, check her item. Before I forget again. Spatula, CA 20, copper. I never made the copper one. She never has the upgrade. I made the copper sword because I thought he'd be useful. go figure. I gotta fight a lot of these battles as well, because with the Profiteer's Purse on, I might as well and get a lot of money. Because the weapons don't cost that much, but... Oh, they're oddly organized. You can hit that guy as much as you want. It makes a difference to me. Next guy, 2C. How do you miss a 94? Well, to be fair, last time I was playing this, I missed a 91. So I assume if you know about Janice, you've played Chrono Trigger, so. Use Magma Bomb. Let's see if you can do some damage. Nope. that guy really is worthless. There we go. I'm gonna have to take that off. It's gonna bug me if I don't. The game is set to recommend for attacks. I don't like that. I like choosing my own. Because I pushed X twice there and it said, hey, you should do 2 then 3 instead of sticking it to level 2. Because I don't like having it decide for me. Because to me it seems like it's telling me the right answer. I like the percentages missing. All the tablets. But, to be fair, I did get 800 bucks there, so that's definitely worth it. Customize... Accuracy Selection Manual. There we go. And there's an item over here as well. Ointment's ointment. It's not that good. You need a couple, but I only ever use them out of battle. I don't think I've really had to use braces and stuff. I had to. Hey, buddy. Braces I've had to do in battle before, because that's a pretty annoying status effect when you're inflicted by... I think it's yellow? Yeah, I think it's yellow. Okay. Of course she has a wind spatula. Or bone, I guess, but... I'm gonna hit him, that's fine. He's not really gonna do much. Hopefully you're having a good night too. It's just too warm here to have a... Ooh, no, I don't wanna hit that one. Between all the thunderstorms and stuff here, it's been, it's too warm to do anything and too warm to sleep. So I thought I'd just make myself a cup of tea and play some games. Like how they're showing the guy gets too damaged, because why not? No, of course you miss, and of course you miss. Okay, go back to Shani. Shani can actually do something. See? Is that so hard? Although, to be fair, I'm coming up against my favorite... is it a boss? No, it's not a boss yet. I think it's a boss the second time you see her. Spatula death. They have to be death, because they're not coming getting back up. Okay. Next time I'll use consumables, I think. I thought that actually there's more than one person that can heal there. You can do this part stealth, too. Oh, goody. I remember minigames. They're a thing. Turn blue's not bad. Yeah. The last thing you want to be in that is in a spotlight there. Because every PlayStation 1 game... I won't mention about what this triangle thing is. It's a save point, but... It's a save point, but it's something different. Okay, let's see if I can still do this. Nope, I remember how. 100. Sure. This is going to be a while, so if you have any questions, feel free to ask. Because you get a really good reward if you do the 100. That's 17. It's always easier starting in the center as well. There you go. I used to try this minigame all the time when I was a kid. No, it's fine. Oh, darn, missed them. There you go. 37. There we go. Oh, darn. Nope. Oh, barely got it. I have no idea what that says, unfortunately. I'm Canadian, and I've never learned to read. I'll assume Japanese. I recognize a couple characters there, so I think it's Japanese, but... Sorry if I got that horribly wrong. Or... There we go. 100. First try. Almost screwed up on the one on the far left, though. Yeah, definitely. I think I can do the 41 as well. Try that in a sec. So I'm pretty sure the... You're gonna hear a lot of the roars because I'm pretty good at button mashing. Forty's pretty simple though. I always wondered how these things function. Like, if they get hungry this quickly. There we go. Like how successes, not how many times they've wanted to be fed. There we go. Just about done the 40. And one more go. Oop. My bad. For some reason I thought I got the one on the left. Maybe that one on the left just hates me. See, now that's a good one. That's going on, Shawnee. Come on. You know, you get one reward each time you beat it, so... It'll be quicker and quicker each time, so this is only 10 successes of... There we go. But yeah, I hope you're having a good night, or a good day, I guess, if you're in Japan. Because right here, it's like 11 o'clock now, so... PM. There you go. Four more and I'm good. There you go. You know what? I am going to... One sec here. I don't feel right doing this. Unless... to answer your previous question, if it is translated properly, it's not very hard. All you guys do is mash X and grab a bunch of stuff from the side. So two more, then I can go into the mansion. So I had to use Google Translate, which obviously has great success rate. But like when I'm on my YouTube channel, the Iron Vest is useful for this kind of area because it has good defense and good evasion and stuff like that. But it's better to dissect and turn to a better weapon because then you can get the iron from it very easily and use it in the long run. Oh, sorry. Didn't realize he was hungry in front of me. I don't have a bronze helmet yet, so I also say, oh, I keep going over here thinking I have to start it. I don't. I have to do the 10, then I'm done. I'm pretty sure he gives you something really, really crappy. There you go. That's all of them one go. Which honestly doesn't take too long. Yeah, actually, to be fair, actually, knee pad's actually pretty decent. Because you don't get it for a while. Right, did I grab the key? I did grab the manor key, cool. So, yeah, that's extra defense. Give me a second here, and I will check what that says. Does this guy have... He already has an ivory helmet on. Give him a bronze mail. And... Yeah, good. We are good to go. But yeah, if you want to send messages, I can put them through Google Translate. I got no issue doing that whatsoever. It won't be properly translated, but I can try to... Oh, don't be sorry. Honestly, if it's easier for you, ask questions in your own language. I can't guarantee Google Translate will translate everything properly, but I'm more than happy to chat with you if in whatever you're most comfortable with. I'm not going to try to pronounce stuff. I can try to give you the best... Just because I can't speak Japanese doesn't mean you shouldn't. Speak whatever you want, and I'll make sure I can answer your questions. I'll keep the window open so I can easily translate stuff. So feel free to send whatever you want. Okay. And I need... No. I don't want it. No. Bad. Nope. Okay, cool. Nope, not in here. All right. So I have to make sure I go around this thing. I don't want to fight them yet because they all swarm you and it's really annoying. I got rid of the other guys over here, and I got quite a bit of money as well, and resources. There we go. Yeah, and because I forgot Kid and she's not in my party, she comes after. Because she's supposed to be here for part of the story. Yeah, but they always give her a reason for staying away. Yeah, I hate this thing. Let's see if I can get it right the first time. I highly doubt I will. I think it's 237 or 235. I'll try 5. Oh, just 2. Okay, so no. That failed. I think it's randomized a little bit too. Just gotta wait for them to come back, I believe. Because he's not changing his dialogue. Goomba stomped. To be fair, I wouldn't mind switching out Gi for Kid. They're so rude, they attack me without asking, so. Let's do this and get rid of him. No, I prefer having, Sarah or Lena in the party over Kid, and Guy needs to be in the party in order to actually enter the gate. As far as I know, I might be horribly wrong about that, so sorry if I am. So I don't really want to use her just yet. You know, I think Sean will be able to kill this guy if I... Yeah, you go. That's the point, that's the perk of having that copper thing there. If I had an iron weapon, it'd be doing a lot more damage. That's why I want that iron vest, is I can kind of break it up and get stuff I'm not supposed to yet because of it. I like how they disguise themselves in the suits. but yet they kill the people or something, don't they? Or do they put them in the jail cell? Nope, they got rid of the bodies, so I assume they're all dead. Somewhere the password's around here. Dragoon's Honor is very good. Oh, that reminds me, I gotta... Yeah. Random numbers won't work. So you follow Glenn here. Oh yeah, the boss, or the enemies drop the roof. It's easier going around the side of the carpet than it is actually going through it. Anyway, they're fire, so. Like that, and should be a good amount of damage with the Maiden Hand. They're wounded. Yeah, I should equip the Dragoon's Honor, though. It's actually a really good item, and you can exploit that. Because there's one point in the game where, if you have Kid, you can constantly fight and run away from a certain enemy, and you can actually get unlimited Dragoon Honors, which are ridiculously good when it comes to it. So, because they raise, like, three stats, I think? Yeah, so they raise up attack by one, the hit percentage, and magic. And there's the Dragoon's Glove as well, which is a little bit better version. But you can get unlimited of these things and get a good amount of... Like, the percentage is the really nice part, too. That goes down to 88. But put the Profiteer Purse back on. There we go. So we'll stay on the top here. Pretty sure he went one more room over. Yeah, because that's the dishwashers. Actually, I'll write this down myself too, so I don't forget. I don't have to walk down here again. Oh, it's 8 to the right and 3 to the left. I guess it is random per game. Oh, right, elements. I got that recover all. Which is definitely going to go on to Sean here. And revive will go on to Sarah. It should probably be lower. We'll do revive plus one then. Because she's going to be in the party for a while, and not having revive is pretty brutal. Sometimes the enemy might take out the good character. So yeah. That's that part. And, oop, sorry. There you go. Next I talk to the guy. Oh yeah, mimics, right? They're a thing. Not too common though, I don't think. I think you only fight a couple of them in a game as well. Oh no, they're not mimics. They're right or wrong, depending on... I'll say the big one. Am I right? If not, it's gonna be horrible. And... Yep, got it right. Cool. Otherwise, I think it severely harms you I'll take Arrow Saucer. It's a good skill. There you go. So she's off doing her own thing, and I'm gonna do this and get another boss fight. Oh no, we're gonna just straight up grab it. Lena's mannerisms kind of match my wife's of I told you and stuff like that, so. Pip over there is interesting as well. German scientist stereotype. See, I'm kind of glad this game doesn't have voice acting, because a lot of it would be racially insensitive, because this was released in, like, I think 1999-ish, or a little bit after 2000. Voice acting wasn't very good back then, so I can only see it being really bad. Or you'd have the other option of it being entirely English voice acting, and that's a problem there, or it'd be Japanese, or another language trying to be the said language, and it'd just be a mess. At least not as good as it could be. Stretchy arms. I always love the stretchy arms they have. Yeah, we will straight up use Fireball 2 on this guy. Sorry, Fireball plus 2. So it should be a decent amount of damage against him. That's fine, you can hit me. That. This hopefully will be able to damage the other guy on the left enough. Well, he's wounded, but he's not going to die anytime soon, so that's annoying. Oh, Bush Basher. That's annoying. And he's okay. Alright. I'll take that. And we will use Recover All, because it's an absolute great element. And doing only 40 for that is actually pretty simple. Quite happy that Shawnee didn't get a... Oh, they're grass. Okay, I can get rid of them. Let's get rid of the guy over here, because I haven't attacked him in a bit. There you go. Well, he's pointless. Well, I got an extra copper sword, so... I'll save me making something. Yeah, they count as bosses for some reason. They're not overly strong compared to the last couple guys. There you go. And this is something special you can do. There you go. Pip is a character you can get as well. Also, there's a silver pendant I should equip as well. It's magic defense. Well, keep it as is then. A very cute little monster. Yeah, so if you come back, you can get her added to your party. So. Sorry, that one didn't come up very well in the Google Translate. Ooh, big giant monster thing. This place takes quite a bit of time, actually, despite me going through the front door, which is the quickest way of doing things. Then again, fighting, I think, a little bit more bosses than normal. I love robots that can rip off their own arm and attack you. Nope, we'll do Arrow Saucer. Because he's yellow and it'll be extra damage. Oh, we're just gonna ignore Guy's turn. decent amount of damage. Yeah, we'll just defend and get everyone's stuff. Oh wow, he's gone crazy. With a lot of attacks. Herself here. But yeah, sorry, but your last comment didn't come out very well in Google Translate, so try it again here. Yeah, I know. It didn't really come up with anything really. Sorry, no. See if I can quickly get a heal off. I'll do Ice Lance, actually. A little bit like Final Fantasy VIII there. Yeah, this guy is... he's not a boss, per se, but he is still pretty annoying. The magma bomb on him. There we go. Because the whole point of him is you're supposed to get around him. Like the... yeah, he doesn't count as a boss. He doesn't give me a star. Everyone's full health. That's good. That's good at least. Get the door here. There's a lot of bosses in this game. When I was doing a boss playthrough of this on YouTube, it was pretty annoying for that reason. Just try to get my windows up so I can keep the Google Translate up, and there we go. Oh, caught me before I was going to do it. Oh well, I guess I'll have to use Magma Bomb +2. There you go. And Mashani. No? Okay, well, we'll try a dash and slash here, though. But you can kind of see on this game how even regular battles like these, like this isn't a special enemy at all. If you don't know what you're doing with the elements or anything on those lines, it can be very difficult. Okay, he's weak, so let's see if we can get rid of him. Nope. Oh, you're doing the thing. You did the thing. Thank you. Yeah, annoying thing about him is you can summon different enemies. Yeah, we'll do that then. No, I don't want to use magic against him because he'll use Peck. And Peck's a little bit too annoying right now. No, it's fine. Switch back to Shawnee and see if I can get rid of him. Okay, so yeah, see, without the auto thing on, it's not changing it around. So if I could, I can input a bunch of, no, he's already dead. I can input a bunch of twos at once instead of having it switch between three and stuff. Sometimes I don't want to always do the max amount of damage, you know, just because. I got a capsule. Capsules actually are really good. They're like tablets, but a little bit better. And now I kill the poltergeist so I can get to the door. Thank you, game. The geometry here is a bit weird. There you go. So many battles. For most RPGs that you can see the enemies on the map, you can normally avoid them, but I think these guys are considered water. Yeah, they are. So if that's the case, we'll switch to Sarah. Do two level two attacks and use the Magma Bomb and see how much that damage does. Yeah, good enough. Two of them right next to each other, apparently, so. That's what I mean, you gotta be careful when you finish battles, because sometimes the enemies do this and just lock you into a same battle. And if you only have one character with like full health and two of them with 1 HP, it's not in your best interest to keep battling. That's fine. She's technically still above HP. Because of that stupid I'm curious how I'm finding bones from the slimes, though. It's a bit weird. Like that. But yeah, everything here tries to kill you. It's quite phenomenal. No. There we go. She has Magma Bomb, so she might as well use it. Thing is, yeah, you gotta be really careful, I was gonna say, because if they hit Shawnee with this, which obviously it does, because it hits everyone, he'll take some extra damage. So, and they're all... Okay, they're... We'll get rid of the Man-at-Arms first here. There you go. Because he is quote-unquote the leader. He hurts more than these guys will ever will. So. Pretty sure his accuracy is reduced a bit now. That's not good. They got hit by the Black Rain and it ended up giving them blind status. This is a little black... squares, based on what element they hit you with, you have a chance of taking on that element's status ability. That's quite annoying. So we will see if we can get rid of this guy. Shawnee should be good to get rid of a few of them with his we're gonna try with Gi then. There we go. Oh, come on. You know, I'll just defend. These guys can get really annoying though, because they have a lot of HP. And again, like, since there's no leveling system in this game, like, you're kind of restricted to what the game kind of gives you, except for random battles, which can give you the occasional stat every now and then. So. Let's see if I can use something with Gi here as an element to get rid of this guy. I think one bomb works, that hits both. There we go. Pretty annoying battle, actually. Because this is after having to beat the Poltergeist, too. So. Hey, I'll be happy to take a heal. A heal's a great move. To be fair, he's not joking. There's traps everywhere in that room. I'm gonna leave that last one there. We're gonna verse the Poltergeist again. I really wish I could switch to Kid, because Kid can steal now since I have a certain amount of stars. The main reason I wasn't using her is because I didn't have enough stars. So. Do this before he tries to stop my green magic. Yeah, is he just gonna summon something? I'll let the beach bomb. Those things are pretty simple. I think even Guy can kill them. Oh, he's summoning too. What are you summoning? Oh, not a dodo. Oh well. They are very cute. I do love the dodos. Here we go. That one seems to be a little bit stronger, because I normally should have about 16 health. But either way, try to get rid of the Poltergeist here. You know, yeah, we'll use dash and slash. Should be wounded at least. Really? Not? Jeez, they have a lot of HP. Nope, poltergeist. I don't want to use magic on the dodo, because if you do that, they freak out. Okay, so defend, defend, and defend. Okay, there we go. We don't worry about him summoning anything else. Because this guy doesn't do that much damage when he's by himself. But I'm more afraid if the poltergeist would summon more of them. Yeah, see there, you can lock in your attacks. The side if you don't have it, so 1, 3, 2, 1. There you go. Dead bird. Yeah, a lot of money from the dodos as well, so I'm always happy to see them get summoned. Because they give you 400 or so by themselves. Ooh, another recover all. Oh wait, no, sorry, that was me using it. Oh. Almost nice. Oh, Zoa. He speaks in all capitals. This guy is all full of exposition, isn't he? Okay. You can actually come back and get that treasure chest, though. Oh, right. Walk above. Random battles everywhere in this place. In other dungeons, they don't have things that fall from the ceiling. Which makes all the difference. Get rid of him. And we'll use Aqua Beam on the other one. And thank you for the congratulations. And he's the same thing as him. He's gonna say no. Nah. Not worth talking to him. Basically, it's... Have you ever played Radical Dreamers? Suck here. Yeah. Alright, one sec here. We're gonna go to the basement again quickly. So I wanna figure out what's on the left side. If you're talking about the path where you have to do stuff with the Radical Dreamers. Oops, sorry, this is the cafe again. Yeah, I have. If it's another game, no, I haven't. Oh, right, random battles. In all its glory. Oh. Oh, there they okay, there is the little. I think they're not fire, so I think I'd be able to use Magma Bomb and get away with it. I'll see if I... No, they are fire. Okay. No, they die in two hits anyway. Let's use Maiden Hand. Didn't die. Yay? Okay, good. Cool. I gotta get a new headset someday. Hey, Magma Bombs are good. I'm happy with those. Just coming from those bats, obviously. We'll go up this way now. Wait. Here you go, yeah. Can't talk to her. Oh, here you go. Don't know how well this is gonna go, but hopefully I picked the right one. I think it's small. Not too sure. I know they're set, so. We'll try small. Yep. Yeah, that I'm getting really lucky. I have no idea which one, but it's one or the other. Ooh, that's really nice. Ooh, meteorite's a really good move. What level is it? Level 2. Awesome. Meteorite's a really nice move. That's a cute little emoticon. Oh, random battles. I keep forgetting about you. If it wasn't for the transitions, this would be like 10 minutes way in the back already. Takes so long. Sarah first. Hit the lantern. Because she's blue, she can do a little more damage. Use Magma Bomb. Let's get some damage on them. That's not bad. It's about half their HP. That'd be one. And then dash and slash for the other one. That's a quick kill, more or less. I got a lot of tablets, I don't mind using one. So one more poltergeist, the golem over there, and whatever's in this room, and then I can go finish the mansion. Because technically all you have to do is get that little thing, go to the right, run through, and it's 8 right, 3 left now, so that's all you have to do. Hey, I don't mind... I don't mind criticals when they're on my side, I should say. And we'll use Arrow Saucer. Okay. Okay, bat's not bad. What else? You're not supposed to exist yet. Yeah, we're gonna get rid of this thing. I'm pretty sure those are from a little bit later. As evidence as he did not die yet. He should be weak at least, his head's droopy down. Come on, just one more. There we go, cool. I should get rid of him. Awesome. Yeah, wraths are no... That's a horrible summon. Because they're from a ghost ship, which is quite a bit later. And they're not hard when you're on the ghost ship, because you're level accordingly, but... If he summons them here, like, that's a pretty brutal summon. This should possibly get rid of... this bat. If I'm lucky. And I am. So, yeah. Sarah can do that. 1, 3 in an element. Oh, he's gonna try to attack me first though. That's fine. I want to use Meteorite. Because it looks really cool. I like it. Meteor Shower is the upgraded version. I actually have a spell I can use. Hey, again, I'll be happy to have capsules. They're strong healing. It's locked. Get rid of this guy, and then we are good to go through that. I can't remember what's through that door, though. I think I had to come back for that one. Try to remember off the top of my head, but I can't. Okay, so... Of course, you missed with the big one. We'll use a meteorite on you, though. Okay, the really cool thing about New Game Plus is you have something to alter time. So if R2 is fast forward and L2 is slow, so you can admire the animations or you can just speed up the battles by 4 times the speed. I wish I'd have that in normal. That's gonna hurt, possibly. Only one, that's fine. That's fine. Do Aqua Beam plus 3 here. That's fine. That's even better if I dodge a second one, yeah. Mega Bomb plus 2. I should have a whack load of money at the end of this dungeon. There you go. And I have Recover All, because I have at least 4. There you go. I gotta do the password here. First, copy your message, see what you sent. That's a prototype time transmission? If I actually set it to... No, it's saying to... Japanese. Are you talking about the robot? Oh yeah, for us for 8, right. It's gonna take forever anyway. So I have to do each one. And 3 left. What if it's possible ever to actually get on the first go and ignore the bottom part entirely? And 3 left? 3 left, yeah. So I write these things down, because it took me like, what, 40 minutes to do all the stuff there? Nope. Running into geometry again. I don't think I can actually kill this guy, though. Yeah, he's just there. So you have to restrict your movement around this castle a little bit. And there's two moons. I am full health, I believe. Yeah, I am. This is a neat little thing. Yeah, let's take off our disguises for no reason. So this is a neat little thing, and I don't quite understand, even after beating this game numerous times, how this has happened. This is Balthazar, and from Chrono Trigger, he was stuck in 2300 AD. So, I don't understand this. Yeah, he is the prophet of time. He's not Gaspar from the end of time, though. And it's all based on how Lavos, again, it's not much spoilers because that's what Chrono is about, is basically screwing and distorting two worlds and making two separate timelines. But I don't understand how he's here, because he was in 2300 AD. And even knowing what comes after and stuff like that, I'm not quite sure. Yeah. So yeah, like he's explaining, Surge is dead in this world. That's right, I can write that one down too. There you go. I always try to look out for names for Pokemon. Trying to go for a shiny fortress right now. Or a shiny Pineco by hatching it. Alright, got a shiny Shuckle and a shiny Zubat in the last couple weeks, and I figure I can go for a third one before Sun and Moon come out. Yeah, back to the point though, is I don't quite understand how he's here, like, even knowing some other stuff. Meaning some things in Chrono Trigger were meant to be ignored and weren't canon. But I always figured it was canon, so it's kind of a weird thing. Get your message into the thing here. Ooh. Wrong button entirely. Gaspar is the one in the end of time where you can change your party members in Chrono Trigger. He's the one dressed in all brown, stuff like that. He is actually in this game as well, actually. Marcy is actually quite an annoying fight, but she actually is blue for an element, so the main reason I have Sarah in my party right now is actually to counter some of the damage that she gives out, because she actually is quite menacing with her attacks. But while I'm here, Sarah should go first. Two level 2s. That's fine. Yeah, no, that's fine. Single attacks work fine. And then Magma Bomb. Do that. Keep attacking her fire, because that's the best thing you can do. And you weaken up her her attacks when she gets around to it as well. I already did that. We'll just have to use Electro Jolt then. Still some electricity, or yellow up there, so... Yeah, Cat's Cradle. Oh god, I hate Cat's Cradle. Nope, no status effects? Okay, I'm happy with that then. We'll use Magma Bomb. Again, reduce that blue power just a little bit. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, that's gonna hurt, so I'm gonna cure right after. Okay, you can hit Gi. I don't mind. He's only a temporary character, really. Maybe we'll use Recover All, though. Yeah, she can be pretty brutal with spells, but only in desperation. Can I get a cheap kill in here? We'll try with Aerosaucer. Okay, cool. That's the end. She can be quite tough. Like, that, I was lucky with that critical. Hey, lots of HP there. I don't mind that. Oh, jeez. Alright. Hey, and I get Ice Blast too. That's going straight on to Sarah then. But the Arcadia Dragoons, the four D.Va Dragoons, are actually really tough. You eventually fight them all together and they hurt. Or three. But yeah, Balthazar is a, I guess, a good person. Okay, I like to recover my stuff. Oh wait, Ice Blast. Gotta put Ice Blast on quickly. So we'll take that one off. And go Ice Blast. Because that's a really strong move. And we'll put the Magma Bomb there and a Magma Bomb here. Oh, sorry, not Magma Bomb. Turn Black. And Shawnee. We'll do this. We'll put a cure in that there. And a fireball instead of an aqua beam. And you know, I'm just gonna leave him as is. He has not done anything this entire time. I just wonder if I can actually see what I'm not supposed to see. But I know you can when you come back. Or are you gonna stay there? You're gonna stay there, aren't you, buddy? Oops, sorry, 3D geometry. 3D geometry. No, it's not gonna let me. Just switch where he's standing. He'll be moving. I should have checked before leaving the room for the first time. Balthazar, Mechthor, Gaspar. Can't remember the fourth one. Four sages from the Kingdom of Zeal. And there's Harlequin. proper English. Having fun with the fact they have accents. I'm not going to bother speaking Canadian and French. It's not worth it. Although it was goofy when I was growing up, because you are bilingual in Canada when you're in school and stuff like that. So the stuff they threw in to kind of confuse regular players, you do understand. So I know enough. She's technically not lying there. Where the heck is that switch? Is that the second one on the left, right? Where the geometry kind of doesn't work as well. There you go. Because it kind of jiggles your character around. That kind of knows me. So all you gotta do is take out the big guy in the back. Really? I guess in the English version, they decided to make her French. I guess because some of the clowns can be considered... like mimes and stuff can be French origin. So how does she speak in the Japanese version? So I'm completely unfamiliar with that. He's not gonna do well. Oh, well, okay. I got to keep Magma Bomb on. That's fine. I'm not gonna need any more magic to... Okay, he's wounded at least, so I think Sarah can finish him off. Well, they say like mon ami, je m'appelle, you know, so forth. My name is my friend, you know, so forth. So I just find it kind of goofy that they gave her essentially a French accent. Photon ray is good. Photon ray can cause a status effect. So I'll put that on Sarah. Because I'm going to need that very shortly. Wow, that's a really good drop. We'll get rid of that. And we'll put that instead of there. And revive can go there instead of aqua beam. Cool. Actually, it's coming on quite nicely. So almost to the end of this place. Even though there's only two different rooms, essentially, and a very weird little dragon feeding puzzle. That's what probably took up the most time. So first of all, beat up the poltergeist. I like how that one came through in Google Translate properly, saying whoops indeed. There you go, Photon Ray. That caused... No, it didn't cause him to have a status effect. That's kind of annoying. Oh, they have way too much HP. What are you gonna do? Nope, just damage. Just damage is fine. I don't want the status effects. This should be... Yeah, that should be the right move to use. Oh, he's gonna summon stuff. Well, that's even better, too. Always with the dodos. I'm gonna check my money after. I'm very curious now. Well, either way, we can get rid of the beach bum here. There you go. I was hoping to save a little bit there, but whatever. Poltergeist. There you go. I shouldn't say poltergeist. It's poltergeist, technically. Comboed. No, we're not doing specials against him. We're gonna do the normal attacks because I don't want him to use Peck. Ice Blast. Since he's weak, I should be able to kill him with that. Oh yeah, 126. That's the first time I did damage over 100. So that's going to be a nice welcoming spell. Huh, still does more stuff. Okay, so that's there. Random battles everywhere. So poltergeist to the left, and then it'd be a safe point in there. And then after that, it'll be in the center room, and then it should be done. There we go. Aqua Beam, here we go. Oh wow, one Aqua Beam kills him, so that means potentially Sarah would be able to take out two of them in one turn. Or one 7 gauge. Oh, either way, I'm still going in here. Yeah, I know. The whole reason it's locked from the inside is because of the poltergeist. The boss coming up is actually very annoying, so I gotta be very careful. Nope, that's fine. I don't mind that. Beach bum and what? Probably a dodo. I think that's in the normal pattern now. Yeah, okay. Which is fine. I guess it's poltergeist. There's a G. So we will get rid of the beach bum here. Oh no, I shouldn't have used Magma Bomb. Oh well, I gotta deal with the Dodo. That's not good. No? Is that gonna freak out? Alright, cool. Okay, I'll take that. Normally when I use spells on him, he always used to freak out, so... Maybe because I haven't attacked him too much this match. Oh good, I got actually the status effect. That was very lucky. I don't normally get those. More capsules, more than happy. Oh, it actually is for... Again, I'm not going to explain the green triangles. They're save points, but there's something else to them. And I love the idea behind them. It's probably one of the smartest things I've seen in video games in a long time. So we will go in here and hopefully not die. This is where color choice is important. I was adamant that he had a large forehead when I was a kid, but he has a hat because you can see it in the same cloth color on his neck here, or the collar around his neck, but the sprite makes it look like he has a giant forehead. Always constantly finding a way to make sure your party members involved in the story don't actually compete in it. See, he has a hat on. Doesn't look like he has a hat on though, does it? Like, look at it. It's the same color as his fur, so it's really hard to tell apart. It's goofy, that's all. And this is gonna hurt though, because he's gonna hurt Shang. 40 damage, not overly bad. Not great though. Like everything, I always take boss battles very seriously in games, so. See if I can get the status effect from Photon Ray on him. Pretty sure there's one at least. He messed up the white field, but I do have an option right now to do. There we go. Okay, so. Use Ice Blast. Definitely gonna harm him nonetheless. If I get the frozen status, all the better. No? Okay. Nope, miss. And... just poke him. Defend. Defend with Shawnee. There you go. Imbecile. Imbecile? Imbecile? There's a lot of different ways you can pronounce that, actually. Either way. Wow, Gi actually did a lot of damage there. It's okay, honestly. If you want to share your thoughts in Japanese, I can, again, try to translate them. It's not like there's not stuff to do that. So don't worry about speaking English to me. Speak whatever is comfortable for you. Yeah, he's already weak, so... Yeah, that's a healing move. That's annoying. Just when you think you're doing well. We'll use Electro Jolt. He hasn't affected that. Here we go, this is annoying. Pretty sure it's the- nope, no, sorry. It's instant death, I think. Miss? Thank you. Not too keen about seeing that move. This is going... I don't want to jinx it, but going surprisingly better than I thought. So. Not the end of the match just yet. He still has some HP. Let's see if I can kill him with a slap. Oh yeah, he got slapped to death. Win. Oh, this guy has a lot of HP now. So yeah, there's the choice of two sides of the same coin. We'll call it that for now. See, I'm pretty sure that's the island from 2300 AD. There's the Frozen Flame. Doesn't show too much of it, but there is a frozen flame there. I also like how she's nice enough to say, don't worry. Gi is completely useless. Oh, clever writing. Not push, she fell, but yeah, close enough. And here's where they... I think they try to get away with something here. Saying the Chrono Trigger. Like, I think that was clumsily written in. Like, oh, we need a connection to the last game. What could we do? Let's call the main character the Time Assassin or the Chrono Trigger and act all coy. And it doesn't really work because the Chrono Trigger was the egg of the beginning and the end from the last game that used to... at the top of the mountain. I'm not going to be... if you don't know anything about that, I'm not going to spoil it, but... Sploosh. Everyone jumps off because it looked like it was fun, right? keep everyone as it is. There's no battles right now. Just wake up in a place that I'm not used to. And here's the whole other problem, is now I have to decide if I want three or four different characters in different paths. So. Because there's... again, like 40 characters or so. So, yeah, basically, Lynx threw the knife, which was poisoned, scratched her, and she succumbed to poison. And they give you an excuse on why you can't travel out of their world they created. Yeah, they're the same character. It's, I can't remember what the daughter's called, but there's Korcha, Macha, Orcha, and... I can't remember the daughter's name. I love doctors who just run out of the room, avoiding responsibility. Now, see, now this is another turning point. Because, like when... So you have Harley Quinn here, interrupting everything. But like when I was about to go into the manor, there's about three or four different ways you can do this. One is you can travel and find the Hydra venom, or the Hydra humor, to neutralize the venom and save her. And that the other thing you can do is ignore her. You can let her succumb to the poison, and you can get another batch of characters that way, which actually are a little bit better than actually the ones you get if you go to... So... Tsukuyomi? Is that her name in Japanese? Sounds actually really cool, actually. Sorry, just a standard Harley Quinn. Hopefully I pronounced it right. It's really cool. I actually learned about different names and stuff like that from... Like, my favorite little thing I found out a long time ago is I play Pokemon on tournament level. So I go to the local tournaments and stuff like that, which is really fun. I really recommend doing it if you ever had a chance. But my favorite Pokemon is Shuckle. I gotta look up his name again, because I always forget it. But its name in Japan is Tsubatsubo, I think? I think that's how you pronounce it. I'm horribly sorry if I butchered it. But I love that name, and I've actually used that as nicknames in the game, because I love the sound of the Japanese name, as well as Shuckle. Shuckle's a cute name too, but... So I always love learning about the language differences and different names. But now we're going to get the pendant, which lets us travel between the worlds, which is actually... Which is possibly the same amulet from Chrono Trigger that Luca had and all them. And I'll get... See, now this is the thing, is I'm not being heartless. I like the other path. I've normally saved her on numerous files, but I like the characters you get from doing this, so I'll say I don't know. And he'll ridicule me. And I'll say there's nothing we can do, because logically, we don't know of anything. I'll keep playing this up. And there goes the Astro Amulet. Because there's no reason to travel to the other world yet. But there's quite a few characters here, and I'm just going to briefly go around and talk to a few of them. Can't talk to her. Here we go. This is the things that you, when you get from battles, you can trade. Oh, sorry, that's extra elements. I do like the music in this game. It's so beautiful. But yeah, it shows how many characters there are on the bottom screen there. Yeah. I want to get back to the place where I can dismantle the iron vest. That'd be the easiest thing to do. I think this is the bar. This is the one stop. I'm going to just do the city, get the boat, and then I think I'll be done streaming for now. Yeah, Orla. She's the... I think she uses fists. Probably drunk right now, though. No, I want to go in there. Okay, fine. Well, let's not go in there then. No, not in here yet. Because I know later you can get the fortune teller of this place as a character, because everyone's. And here's where you get the goofy thing here. I need to borrow his boat. So Korcha is a wuss when it comes to matcha. The thing is, I don't like Korcha as a character to use in battle. He's not very useful, at least to me, and the parties I like to have. But Matcha, though, she has brute strength. So she's really fun to use. Mel, that's the little girl's name. Yeah, she's amazing. I like her as a character much more. So you can unlock more frames in the game for how you play. I don't have the one I want just yet, so I'm going to keep it as a steel frame. Yeah, a lot of the characters have accents. Pierre has an accent. Kid. Can you keep bugging her? No. But everyone has some sort of accent in this game. And it's a nice touch. It's not everyone just speaks plain English or one language or whatever. So I'm going to go talk to the shaman now. And I should be able to go back into the bar after, if I remember correctly. Because you can get the doctor and the barkeep as members as well. Sorry, the shrine maiden, not the... Stina's amazing as a character. Again, they're not very subtle slipping in the references, because digital distortion is what Lucia said in Chrono Trigger about how to describe them. So we'll ignore the green triangle for now. But yeah, everything about this game is really nice. When it got released, like, I was one of the very few people who actually really enjoyed it. A lot of people kept comparing it all the time to Chrono Trigger. And rightfully so, it is a sequel. Okay, I can go back in here now. That's good. Nope, can't recruit her yet, so I guess that's after you get the doctor. I'll worry about elements and stuff. I got quite a good haul when I was in the Viper Fortress, so I don't think I'm going to worry too much about buying some. Let's see if I can talk to the doctor. I'm pretty sure the doctor joins you after... this kind of scenario. Yeah. This is also a really nice game to play through multiple times, like Chrono Trigger. There's a lot of different things you notice, a lot of small things. So I gotta talk to Macha and take the boat. And soon after, I'll be getting rid of Pierre for my party, or Guy. I'm going to put him on the side. But so it's like I just said, but I'll reiterate. There's no way you can get everything in one playthrough. It's impossible. Everything is very subtle, very everything you do in this game has consequences. And because of those, you don't get certain characters. That's why I love matcha. Korcha has to bribe that person. Matcha just screams. So one last thing before I finish here. I've been going for... It's almost 1 a.m. here, so I should be going to bed soon. There's Glenn. So yeah, Glenn is one of the characters which I'll be using. I'm pretty sure he's a green innate element. Is a kidnapped person in this still? No, maybe it's in the other world. Again, this is why I like you getting her, because not only do you get her as a character after this scene, but what she does when she leaves is amazing too. Definitely let him join. He's one of the better characters, too. And unlike Pierre, he actually is useful. And Glenn shall stay Glenn. Because he is the reincarnation, more or less, of Frog. Or he is who he is. But I'll take Sarah out of the party briefly. So I can switch Pierre's stuff back and forth. Oh, of course Macha should join. Yeah, he definitely is Frog. And Macha stays Macha because she's one of a kind. So... Yeah, but if you don't take her in your party, but still accept her, she does this, which is amazing. And she swims back home. Through ocean currents. Alright, so before I stop for the night, we are going to put that on him. I got an extra bronze sword. Take those two off. And for you... Oh, you already have those. Oh well. Profiteer purse. That's good. That helps you put like fire onto your weapons and stuff like that if you use like the level 1 skills. So it's really useful. And we'll do that because that technically keeps it the same, but I get plus 1 defense as well with Ivory Helmet. I should get the bronze helmet though. It's probably a better thing. And, oops, sorry, wrong button. Thank you. Now how do I do this again? How do I do this again? Oh well, we're just gonna have to remove all and do it again. So we're gonna take Pierre out of the party now. Because he's just not worth it. He doesn't have the stats for what I want. So ice that and arrow saucer, because he technically is green. We'll do a cure plus 2 to make it worthwhile. Turn yellow to actually, oops, sorry, turn yellow should be a low one. I should have to have that plus 2. We'll do arrow saucer here. He can have tablets, fireball, and turn yellow. And his level 4 skill can be an arrow saucer. Yeah, no, that's perfectly fine. So now, I have to board the boat here. But by leaving Kid more or less to die from the poison, you ignore one giant side quest for no reason before you come back here and do the exact same thing. So we will land in Arnie Village here. I do love this music so much. And we will use, for the first time in a while actually as well, the teleporter. We'll move Glenn over by one. So there it goes there. There you go. So now we have Sarah back. So we have the healer, we got two attackers, and that's a good synergy of a team. And the last thing I need to do before I stop playing, this music is so beautiful, is I need to remove, okay, thank you. I guess you can't push menu when you're near the thing. Like I said, it's good getting rid of the iron vest that you win from that for an item, because it helps you in the long run, like really, really long run. Going back to the smithy now. Oop. I swear 3D geometry is going to be the end of me one day. So now I want to dismantle my iron vest to get one iron. And get rid of that one to get another piece of copper as well. And forge. Yes. Is that one I want to forge? Oh, I'm missing the carapace. Oh, that's annoying. Can I dismantle anything to get that back? No, that's the one that's already equipped with, you can get mithril from these things. That's the other thing I used to harvest them for. That's a really good metal, but you're not going to be able to find anyone to smith anything like that right now. The silver earring takes up iron. Go figure. Oh, you know what? I'm not going to need the silver. No. Sorry, it's equipped. Okay, never mind. Ah, I should be fine, actually. Unless the knee pad really is. No, just that. Either way, I got that, so I'm happy. Also, as well, since I haven't had that purse on for a long time, I have $14,000. Yeah, they're talking about the rainbow shell from Chrono Trigger as well. All the references back and forth. But nonetheless, we are going to have a wonderful 3 more attack, but increases your hit percentage. And it is worth it. It is worth sacrificing that kind of 2 defense for 3 attack. Because in this game, 3 attack goes a long way. And it's definitely worth it. And it kind of pushes you ahead before enemies start dropping iron, and you have to go back and smith everything and do whatever. So, we're going to see if Van Gogh wants to join us. Is he still being mopey? No, he's going to be mopey. I'm pretty sure you can get a lot of characters when you can go back and forth between worlds. And he might be one of them, so I might not be able to get him no matter what I try. His father's still here as well. I know, I remember now, yeah. You go back and forth and... Although Van in your homeworld is actually quite greedy, and his father loves art. And it goes back and forth. It's much like the scarecrow guy and all those other people. Like, everyone has a counterpart, more or less. How are you doing, buddy? Let's see if I can get the Exorcist as well before ending. There's a lot of stuff to do in this game. I'm trying to get... Yeah, here we go. Having a funeral. A Mexican wrestler priest, because of course he is. Oh, he's really weird. Fact, he's a Mexican priest. Why would you crate him? What purpose is there? Why is he stronger characters in the game? Well, to be fair, he's a wrestler, so that's probably why he's a stronger character in the game. So weird. Also, I find it really odd. Every time I'm about to possibly end my stream, people always surge in for some reason. Please, come with me, Mexican wrestler. Because that's what I want. And I do want to change his name. So we're going to change into my best friend's name. Because why not? What levels? 13 strength. The thing is, the more you use characters as well, the more they level up. So the ones that you don't use will always stay weak, per se. So it's good to have a constant flow of characters going in and out, but it actually pays off to actually stick with the same kind of the same characters to make them really strong. And on your next playthrough, switch them up. I think for the most part, everyone shares the star levels, but they don't share the enemy stuff. Oh, so you can do this because, of course, you can. Yeah, weights. Super macho. So there you go, that's another character gone. Because, of course. Yeah, okay, nothing down there. And I have to check if Guile is around, and I have to check if... Who's the other character? I think the Straw Man is going to be the other one. In Arnie Village. And then after that, we'll have to see how things go. Oh yeah, sorry, Guile's in the bar. At least they didn't censor it to cafe or anything. I hate when games do that. So we'll go to Arnie Vich. Okay, I'm running by it by accident. Zoom because of loading. You can't hear sound. Should be. Let me know if you can hear it now, because on my side everything's fine. Give me a sec here. every single time I have a dog or a pet on a video game, like Stardew Valley, Harvest Moon, Secret of Evermore, anything like that, I name it Toast. It's tradition. So it's a video game dog. It gets named Toast on my game. And if there's two animals, I have issues. I have to think up a second name. I'm really bad for that. But yeah, let me know if the sound is good on your end, because I can hear it on my end. I click the unmute button on my side. See if I can get the scarecrow. I might have to, Yeah, he's talking about the same stuff, so I'm pretty sure he's the same. Yeah, I don't think you can don't think you can get him until you can go back and forth between worlds, or if you manage to grab him before coming to this world, which I should have done. Which is a bit of a shame. Come here. There you go. I was being smart before when I was actually ignoring the village. Okay, Divine Dragon Falls. But, yeah, board the boat quickly. I'll see if I can do one more boss battle before ending, I think. If he's there. I don't know if he will be or not. I think he is, because this has black smoke on it. Yeah, cool. And there's Harley Quinn once again. Now Harley. I don't really care when you burn this place to the ground. But yeah, so Harley is actually a pretty decent little boss. I wouldn't really say she's a tough boss. She's not a pushover either. And she is Black Element as well. Actually, we'll use Meteorite on her. Photon Ray. Let's get rid of the black on the field, or the field effects. I say that, then she's gonna do that. Nah, that's fine. Switch that over. Nope, I wanted 4. That's annoying now. Yeah, she's already pretty weak. She's not a strong boss, per se. Oh, right, yeah, so the other thing about this as well is, like in Chrono Trigger, they have double text and triple text and stuff like that. And because Glenn has his... I'll go over here. Because he has his level 3 thing going, which is normally a green one. Because you have two swordsmen, like Glenn and Chrono, or Glenn from Chrono Trigger and Chrono, you can do X Strike if you have their things in a double tech. So likewise with on this game is, I forgot about that as well. Is I was going to originally use the holy move, but it's going to let me do this unless I waste my attack and then use it. But so you can do kind of double techs here, so both of them will go. Don't know if that'll be the end of her though, because it's, yeah, okay. She doesn't have a lot of health, but like I said, she can be really annoying. And I think she has taken me out once before, but I think that was based on a fluke, really. Okay, there we go. I got a photon beam. That's good. And poof. There she goes. This is my favorite character. Yeah, Radius has always been my favorite character to use in the game. He has some of the better skills, stats. He tends to be more well-rounded than other characters. No, oh, sorry, I can move. Yeah, Dario is a hell of a thing in this game, too. I can guarantee I'm probably going to dedicate an entire stream just to attempting him. I've never had good luck versus him. Some of the bosses on this game just go from like 0 to 60 immediately. Dario, one that begins with M, which I'm not going to spoil. But he is just a beautiful boss fight. That's actually the main reason I'm doing the stream. And continuing it and stuff like that and playing it. So I want to verse those two bosses again. And of course, there's the cameo fight with Ozzy and Slash and Flea. there's a special area where you can fight them as well. Which is it's an okay battle. They're not very difficult by the time you get to them. They can be annoying if you let the momentum swing in there. There you go. It's all healed. Don't think there's anything here I can steal, really. Yeah. And then he stops you. I think, doesn't he? No, there's a scenario that comes up later. We'll see. Oh, let's talk to him quickly again. If not, I think that'll be it. I think that's good enough for now, because I kind of started the next push on this game. I've been playing for 3 hours. I think I already saved like an hour ago. So I really should save before I push my luck again. Yeah, just gonna... Okay. Oh no, Radius from the other world joins you, I think. Or no. No, it's this one that joins you. Because you have to do something with the Massive Moon. Because, of course, with Chrono Trigger, you have to do Massive Moon. But we will take this. No, we'll pull back for now. I'm not doing that right now. Because that is... Yeah, Goldove. That's fine. And I'll quickly do this as well. Oh, wait, no. It's in the other world? Yeah, it's in the other world. Okay. It's a lot of stuff I'm getting switched back and forth. The home world, I gotta go to the triangle. I think this is another town. I think the other complaint people had about this game was it was a little bit too small compared to Chrono Trigger's world, which is really big and expansive. Let me do that again. I love how they give you access to this place. Like, it's pretty far ahead. But I guess that's okay. Like, you can explore the world. I don't care. Okay. That way. I can't remember if there's a store here you can actually buy stuff from. These are the demi-humans, so... Outcasts in this world. There's a black dragon. I really should be careful now, because I don't want to screw myself over. I know he doesn't attack you, though. Even if he did, I think I'd be fine. Yeah, he's not going to talk to me. He's one of the six dragons representing the elements in this game. One being black, one white, one green, one yellow, one red, and one blue. The blue one's the most annoying as far as I remember. Okay, so unless you are the... There you go, yeah. There's something here I used to buy to exploit. Yeah, they had the... There we go, the strengthens. I'll buy four of those. Yeah. You know what? We'll just buy four of each, I think. And I'll work those into my stuff. I love stat changes in games. Oh, I don't have enough money anymore. I go broke. Oh well, that's fine. I got the attack ones as well, and that makes a big difference in this game. It makes a... where does this go again? No? Okay, cool. Either way, I think that's it. I'm going on 3 hours, so... I'll be good. When's the last time I actually did save? At the four and a half hour mark. That was like... Yeah, an hour ago, yeah, so I was pretty close to that. Just quickly sail back. I want to listen to the music again when I log on. It's honestly some of my favorite music I've ever had. The pleasure of listening to in video games is this overworld theme here. Shores of Another World. Beautiful. Either way, I'm done. So I'll save it again, so I actually save it on the island I want. I don't have to buy any equipment. So, and even if I didn't, if I needed to, I have the purse to increase money drops. And we saw how useful that was, just going through one dungeon and getting a crap ton of stuff. But yeah, it's 1:15 in the morning, so I should go to bed. Thank you so much, Chuxna, for keeping me company. It's nice chatting with you. It's nice learning a couple things, like names and stuff like that. So, hope you have a wonderful day. I think, if I remember correctly from where I am, Japan is... I want to say it's about 15 hours ahead. Or 14. So if that's the case, have a good evening, I believe. And yeah, I always say, I always announce on Twitter when I'm streaming. And if you follow me here, you'll see when I go live. So yeah, I hope everyone has a wonderful... Is it tomorrow's Wednesday? No, today is Wednesday. Anyway. Everyone have a great time, a great day, great lunch, great evening, great night, whatever. Take care.